Alright, we have more than 100 subscribers on our YouTube channel, and that's very exciting. So today we are going to announce the winner of manual cement block machine. So we promise that when we reach over 100 subscribers on our YouTube channel, we will give somebody a manual machine. On our big premises, we do manufacture cement block machines. We are manufacturing manual machines and mechanic machines. We manufacture diesel, electric, and petrol-operated machines. And they're all in two categories. There's one machine that drops three blocks, and then there's one that drops five blocks. The manual machines, they drop one block each, but the one that makes the smaller blocks drops two blocks each. So thank you very much for subscribing to our channel. And we also, if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and press the notification button so that you can be notified whenever we posted new videos. I also wanted to talk about what I heard on one of the platforms on YouTube. This platform is a platform that has got a lot of African Americans, and there was discussions where they discussed about why is it that in Africa, we as Africans are not going into manufacturing, and why is it that all the time, all the stuff that we're using in Africa is coming from overseas. And then I also commented there, and I explained to say that most of the times we are people in Africa don't have the capital to start the manufacturing business, and also we are not being supported by our governments when it comes to that field. I can give an example. If you come in a place like Malawi, you'll find that in all the quarries all over Malawi, they are not owned by Malawians. There is no single Malawian who owns a quarry area. I think that what we should have done is that most of the quarries should have been owned by Malawians. What our governments should have been doing is buy machineries, and after buying the machineries, the government will have a little bit of stake in the business, and then they give the opportunity to our graduates, engineering graduates, to run this business. After some time, when the business has grown, the government can pull out of the business. Because if you can see in Uganda, what the president of Uganda did, he supported some graduates there who, from the engineering university, who developed an electrical car. The government there, the president, helped this business, and the government of Uganda has got a stake in the business. I understand they've got about 94% shares in the business. The rest is for the graduates. And I'm sure as time goes by, when the business grows, the government is going to pull out. That's what I think that our government should be doing. There are some kind of businesses that we should let our graduates to give them opportunities so that they can run. But not only that, also our graduates, they need to have start creating the mentality of entrepreneurship. And I believe that in Africa, most of our graduates don't have the mentality of entrepreneurship. Why am I saying this? There's a lot of people who are very creative, but who are not educated. I can give an example. Here in Lilongwe, when you're going to Nchinji Road, there was a young man who developed a tractor. It was a nice tractor that he was actually using this for people to transport people's stuff from the fields when they're harvesting. He also, some people would hire him to go to town to buy goods using this tractor. I think as a graduate engineer, one should have been interested to go and visit this guy and see how you can collaborate with him, help him to improve this tractor so that in the future we can start manufacturing these tractors and selling them in Malawi. I can give another example. Myself, I'm not a graduate, but I do come up with a lot of innovative ideas, which I do research online, and also some of them which I brought when I came from South Africa. One of the examples is the pillar mold. The pillar mold is actually a mold that produces a pillar block that can be used as a column. And this pillar block can be used when you're building upstairs, when you're building workshops, like this workshop we have used some of these pillars. But when you're making that column, we're using these pillar blocks, you don't use any wood shattering. But currently in Malawi, all the upstairs houses, when they're building them, they're using wood to make shattering so that they can make these columns. And this actually is not good for our environment. But I have tried to reach out to many engineers. They're not interested with this column. If we could have taken advantage of this, and I work together myself with an engineer, we can go and try he will go and do some calculations, and if this column can pass, we can actually lobby with the government and say to them that this is an option that they should be taking. All the government buildings that are being built must never use columns that are casted using wood shattering. They must start using columns that are using pillar molds, which means that all the structures that are being built, we can protect that idea for Malawi, and all the buildings that are being built, whether by government and NGOs and corporates, they will be using this type of mold. Me and that engineer will be in business, so good business. So I think that most of the engineers in Malawi, they're not being very, having the entrepreneurship spirit. If I was a graduate myself, I would be sitting around, looking around people who are very creative and trying to to work with them, collaborate with them, and try to see with how we can manufacture goods in Malawi, because there's a lot of creative people in Malawi who are doing so many things. But it's very unfortunate when a person who is creative comes up with these things, and then you find these so-called educated people, they lobby to make sure that this person has been put down, or maybe to be arrested. We have seen that before. We've seen a young boy who 9 years of age, developed his own radio station, which he was able to broadcast in the village. We found big people going there, arresting this young man. What was the excuse? They say ignorance is not an excuse. But I mean, why do you think that there are people who, whenever they hear about these cases, they come from the West, they come down, and they take this young man and take him to the West? This is because they know that it is very fascinating to see a young man of 9 years of age come up with a radio station. What they do is they get interested, they take this young man overseas, and to them, that young man becomes a case study. They want to understand, how does a person who has got limited resources come up with a radio station? And these things are supposed to be done by us in Africa. When we see these kind of people, the lecturers at the university should be able to take these young people, take them to the university, work around with them, so that the graduates could understand how did a person who has got limited resources, who doesn't have the education, is able to do something that is normally done by people who are very educated. In Africa, we are killing intelligence, we're killing creativity, we should be embracing it. We should stop this, allowing these people to come here and take our people and take them overseas. Look what happens. What happens to most of these young people? When they go there, they're always going in universities, making talks there in the universities, because when they go there, the students there, they're using these people as for research and also as case studies. And most of the times, we never hear anything else happening to these young people. So yes, let's start trying to embrace creativity, and those people who are creative, who are not well educated, those who are educated should work together with these people so that in Africa we can start manufacturing. In Malawi, one of the examples is my company. We have started manufacturing mechanic machines, and we are planning to start manufacturing tractors in the future. We will be manufacturing agriculture equipment. But what I'm going to do, when my business grows, every time I hear that there's a young man who's creative in the village, I am going to go and get this young man, bring him in the city, I'll pay for his school fees, and I'll work together with this person so that we can empower this person. We can try to get harness his creativity and manufacture goods. I think and I believe that my company is going to be one of the companies in Africa that's going to amaze a lot of people, because we are going to produce a lot of our equipment, whether it's agriculture, whether it's in the medical, whether it's going to be also in the construction industry. The reason why this is going to happen, because we are going to embrace talent, and we are going to empower such talents. So yes, if we want Africa to develop, we need to start thinking outside the box. Thank you.